Hello, grade 8s and 9s. I'm on page 28 and 29 of your books, and I will look at recording credit transactions. Okay, so there's different credit transactions that we can look at. Okay, the first one is when we record a transaction in the creditor's journal. Now, creditor's journal is a journal where we buy something from a supplier, or that we buy on credit. Okay, so we don't pay for it immediately. We only have to pay later. Sometimes creditors allow us a certain period of time to pay it without any interest, and that is what we're going to record in the creditor's journal. Okay, so normally it's the creditor's journal of the specific business. Okay, it's your business for a specific month of a year, and we write CJ there. There's a document which is the invoice number. That's the day. The D is for the day. The name of the creditor is the person that you're going to pay money towards, or the person that you bought from on credit. Okay, folio number we will look at a bit later. Creditors control is the amount that we paid for the transaction, and then whatever we put in the creditors control column, it's almost like your bank column in the CPJ and the CRJ. That same amount must be somewhere in these columns on the right. Okay? And these columns will be given. So, say for example, there's a trading inventory and a stationery column, it means it's transactions that we do often. Okay? Any other transactions that we don't do often, or any other accounts that we don't often use, we will put in the sundry accounts. Okay? So then we will put the details here. Let's say something else, consumables that we bought, then the consumables details will be here and the amount will be there. Okay, so that's a credit. That's when we buy on credit, and that increases the liability. Okay, that increases the liability. So if we think about that, if we increase the liability, our liabilities increase on the credit side. So that means this amount, whatever this amount will be at the end, this amount will be credited. Okay, so creditors control will be credited, and all the other accounts that we have here, or that we have in the sundry accounts, will all be debited. Remember, we must have a certain amount of credits and a certain amount of debits, and these debits, these amounts will, if you add them together, will be the same amount as the amount that we've got as the total in the creditors control column in the CJ. Okay, so that's when we buy on credit, so the liability increases. Then there's two other journals, the creditors allowances journals. Let's say we bought from somebody, but we're not happy with the trading inventory or stationery that we bought. Maybe it's faulty, or maybe it's it doesn't work or whatever. So now we're sending this back to the creditor or the supplier. So if the CJ increases the liability, the creditors control, the in the CAJ, creditors allowances journal, when we're sending it back, that means that the liability will decrease, because if you send your stock back to someone, you don't owe them that anymore, because it's not at your business anymore. If you send back the stationery, your liability will therefore, if this is the liability will decrease, and as we know, the liability decreases on the debit side. So that's why we will debit creditors control the amount, whatever the amount is, the final amount, and then we will credit all the other accounts. In essence, it will mean that trading inventory, which is an asset, will decrease, and that is correct, because if your assets decrease, we don't have that trading stock anymore. We sent it back to the supplier, and if it's an expense, stationery will normally be debited. So if you want to decrease the expense, you want to make it less, then you have to put an amount on this side. Okay? All right, so we will look at a couple of examples. So the full amount will be debited. All the allowances will be on the in this column, on the first column, the creditors control column, and all the other accounts will, so the first column will be debited, all the other accounts will be credited. Okay, so that's the creditors journal, creditors allowances journal. All right, so CJ increases the liability, CAJ decreases the liability. And then there's one more, which is the creditors ledger. Now, this is where we look at a specific creditor. So everything that happens in the CJ and CAJ, we will, that is for all the creditors. So we put everything in the CJ and CAJ. But the creditors ledger, we will look at each specific creditor, which means we are going to take, let's say it's John Doe is our creditor. We're going to write all the transactions that has to do with John Doe in here, the date, that's obviously the month and the day and the details. Okay, it's an invoice or it's a credit note or whatever. And then we've got your debit and your credit. Now, debit, if we look at liabilities, liabilities increases on the credit side and decreases on the debit side. And that's exactly what we're seeing here. If we put an amount on the credit side, it means it increases the account of the person. If we put it on the debit side, it means it's either paid in the CPJ or it is there's an allowance that makes it less. All right, so that's the video on overview of credit transactions.